Get motivated with Mr. Smiles, Vinny Chopra. He is also known as Mr. Enthusiasm. He will share and challenge you each week on great topics, on how to get excited, how to really make things happen in your business, and change your life for the better. Here is Vinny with this week's Motivation Inspiration.
Motivation Power Talk with Vinny Chopra, also known as Mr. Smiles. I am your co-host, Alicia Jabrell, and today I want to say good morning, Mr. Smiles. How are you?
Good morning, Alicia. How are you? Doing well here in California?
Good. No, I'm doing well also. I'm here in Texas, but today I want to talk about mindset. We have done a couple podcasts on mindset, but let's talk about what mindset has to do with, you know, in the multifamily business. Having a positive mindset, and then what a negative mindset will do to you in the multifamily business if that's the mind you have.
Oh, sure. You know, see, the mindset plays a very big, important role. I mean, as you know, people say, I have a negative mindset, I have a risky mindset, risk-taking, or, you know, I've got an entrepreneurial mindset. Okay, that's a big one. As a businessman, one has to always have a very strong entrepreneurial mindset, I would say. Positive also. Positive can be too positive, where you are not looking at the realistic pictures or realistic situations or actual situations. And I know a lot of people say that, Vinny, you are very positive all the time. But to be truthful, I portray that way, and I do look at my whole thinking is, you know, thinking about looking at a situation in a more positive twist. Yes, but the negative situation has its own effects. And we have to really make sure that we understand the risks that are involved in that particular situation. So again, you know, the whole mindset game is all in between our ears, right? It's from the experiences we have had. It's from the lessons we have learned, and it's from the intelligence that we have gathered, possibly, to be able to look at whatever the negative situation hits in our life to find out, okay, what are the consequences? All right. If I don't do this, what will be the consequence? If I do this way, what will be lesser consequence, I guess? And then if I do this to remedy the situation, you know, it's going to take it away off my plate. And then, of course, the positives will come out of the whole situation. Again, you know, people like to be always in the nice things happening in the business. We get used to that. You know, I don't want to listen to some negative situation that just happened at my apartment complex in Texas yesterday. The whole transformer blew up. The fuse blew up. Okay. Six buildings had no power. So what, as a CEO, I can do when my asset manager texted me, I said, oh my gosh, okay, what's the next step? Did we call the city, center point and all that? And they came and they said, no, it's on our property side of the meter. Holy cow. All right. Wow. So they don't want to touch this side of the wiring. Now, what's the next step? All right. We have to call my asset manager, regional manager. They kept on calling so many electricians and nobody will show. And they said, oh no, we can't touch that. We cannot do this. So they call like 12 different places. Again, we could have just gone and, you know, the mindset was, okay, we got this situation. What is going to happen to the groceries of six buildings of the residents when it all thaws out in the refrigerator, in the, all those things. See, you got to look at mitigating the risk.
Yeah, because, I mean, there's so much more. I mean, you have to think about this. They're not going to have refrigerators.
Exactly.
All the groceries, they're going to lose everything.
Exactly. So every half an hour, every 15 minutes, electricity is not there. That's going to be more and more and more, consequence. All right. Irate residents, and you know, maybe even
the pissed.
Exactly. So then the thing was, okay, I have to make a decision. What it's going to take? how I reached out to my broker friends. I reached out in Houston, a lot of people. And then, you know, we got my manager also, other people there started calling. Come to know after about 1.5 hours that this one electrician will charge $5,000. Holy cow, $5,000 to put a switch.
Yes, one switch. But you know what? That switch would have cost you so much more.
I know. Exactly. So again, you know, I'm just trying to say that because that just happened yesterday and we were able to restore the power and everything. But you have to have the mindset of solving the problem. That's what I want to say, because the time factor is very important, depending on the severity of the, you know, situation that comes in our lap. And like this, as a businessman, I come across so many instances, and you have to just say, okay, what's the risk and reward? What's the cost involved in it? And who's going to get it done in the shortest period of time? So mindset, like you asked me, you know, starting the podcast, how do I keep positive mindset? I think the biggest thing I look at is it has to be a win-win situation. I mean, you know, every situation in our life brings its own ups and downs. A lot of time when the things are going great, everybody loves it, right? I love it too.
Of course.
You know, but the thing is, the idea is to say, okay, I'm going to face the challenge. That's the number one thing, right? I mean, how can people really get in that mindset frame, facing the challenge right away and analyzing the situation right away, and then looking at the consequences and that
risk and reward.
Exactly. You know, who is going to get hurt or get the benefit? And then not only that, how much it's going to cost if there is negotiation power involved. Definitely, you know, you want to save the money, but at the same token, I was willing to write $5,000 check and they want your credit card and everything approved.
Yes. Of course they do.
Talking got involved very quickly, all that stuff. So I think, again, you know, mindset plays a big, important role in our life every day. Now, what will be the negative mindset? Okay, I just thought about it. Okay, if I found out about it, I said, why us? Why it happened? What fuse? Who did not do the job right? Or what happened? You know, all that stuff, right? There was an overload somewhere in the building, which got the fuse, you know, turned out, right? You know, so all those things are also would have taken more time to just harp on the situation and delay it more and more and more and try to find the blame, you know, what happened, how it happened, and so forth, rather than mindset of, okay, action, cure, massively getting it fixed.
Love it. So it's not just about like finding the blame. It's about how to fix the problem.
So true. I mean, you know, in life, many times, I think we all are accustomed to first blaming ourselves. Then we blame others, you know, and say, okay, first, poor me, why me? God, why me? You throw at this, you know, juncture, all these, you know, negative things in my life, ups and downs. The second part is then, you know, okay, what happened? Who triggered it so that it has come in my lap, you know, this bad situation?
We
have to kind of analyze it quickly, I think is the word. Bouncing back is the other word I use myself in my thinking. I just say, okay, you got it. So what can you do about it? So for example, I may share something else what happened, and it's actually so current right now. I'm just kind of showing this whole cut. I was at our rental house right here, and Monday I had to fly to Atlanta for a 20-hour trip. Just going there Monday, meeting with my staff there, team members, and also meeting with the broker that we are listing a property there, and then come back. But on Sunday afternoon, evening, I fell, and I was like looking at this fence.
I remember.
Yeah, and it just cut so much on my thing. And I just thought about it. I said, okay, Vinod, you got it. Now let's just take care of it. And I just kept the ice on it for so long that it stopped the bleeding, which was good. Otherwise, I had to go to hospital and get some stitches done, right? It got cut so much. But then I said, okay, what's the next thing now? You know, Neosporin, or, you know, putting something so that I don't have to go to doctor, urgent care, or hospital. They might say, you can't fly tomorrow. So all those things were going through my mind. So mindset was that it's not that big a deal. Even though I was bleeding all over, I just said, okay, it's not that big a deal, Vinny. You'll be okay. And I didn't even tell my wife when I came home. She was sharing that yesterday.
Oh, she was probably mad she lay her there.
No, I mean, you know, I had handkerchief on it and this and that. I said, by the way, you know, I need to just change this Band-Aid because our tenants had put the Band-Aid because I fell in my own house, rental house. So I couldn't sue that. No, I was
not. No, you can't sue anybody. But
I know, I know. They said, well, the owner got hurt in his own place, you know. But anyway, but the whole thing was that, you know, it just got that whole thing. And I traveled and I accomplished everything. And in just about day and a half, the wound is even better. I think by having the right mindset, it just took me out of the frame of mind that it's a pretty bad, you know, whatever, God, what happened and this and that. I even thought about it. I think I texted you or John. I said, you know what? I hadn't gotten hurt for a while. So God just kind of gave me this hurt a little bit.
A reality check.
Yeah, a reality check, you know. So it's a different mindset. You know, you just say, okay, I got it. Okay, what can I do about it? And then to be able to live with it, to fix it and do all that stuff, right?
Love it. No, and I like how you brought like the mindset into you having to your real life story of how, you know, your business went to hell in a handbasket for a second.
Yeah. I mean, you know, when it happened, I said, I couldn't believe it. I did it to myself. Then I said, oh my
God. It happens. I'm a klutz. I know.
I know. And it was like I just jumping from the top of this wall. I thought I would have steady, you know, my foot on it. But anyway. but
yeah, I love it.
Yeah.
Love story. I love the details on the story. I think that's awesome. But Vinny, thank you very much for today. So do you have any advice for somebody who is, like, honestly, like you had an entire thing go bad on your business and then it happened to you personally. So if somebody is in that negative mind space, we're like, oh, you know, why me, why me, why me? What's your advice? What's your golden nugget of advice?
You know, I would say that, again, we always want the right things happening in our life. And the world is, you know, full of all the ups and downs. And many times we sometimes feel whatever bad thing comes in our life that we are the only people. And that's not true. See, that's just not true. I think a lot more people have different ups and downs in their life and we cannot really, you know about those things. So whenever God gives us that hard time, we need to just look at it and say, okay, God gave us, maybe God gave us because I can grow in this situation, or I didn't take care of something. That's why it happened, right? And I also am a firm believer that what's happening with me, or when anything happens to me, or business or personal or whatever, that it was supposed to happen. Oh my gosh. Just to think in that term, that it was supposed to happen, and it happened to you, you can realize much better solutions. You can think through very creatively coming out of that solution much faster than harping over it and digging ourselves a well, call it, right? You know, because our negative mind can take us down and down and down and down in a spiral. But if we can hit head on, that's the thing, you know, head on, I got it. It happened. It had to. So like my attitude changed, you know, when I thought about it.
Yeah.
You know what? When was the last time I got hurt? My mindset, you know, for many years.
I heard it in your text messages.
I know. You know, so that positive mind gave me strength to really go through my whole trip, 4-hour flights and 4.5 hours. Within 24 hours, we were gone and coming back and meetings and all that, you know. So it was a very productive meeting, to say the least. So...
I love the personal stories. I love to see the cause and effect. I think cause and effect is huge. And positive effect is so positive and so amazing. And thank you so much for your time today.
Oh, thank
you. I so appreciate it.
Thank you, Alicia. See you next week.
All right, guys. This is Motivation Power Talk from Mr. Smiles. Until next time.
You will be amazed at the insights Vinny will share each week. He will share his experiences. He has taken $7 to over $220 million portfolio in commercial real estate. To reach Mr. Smiles, text the word syndication to 474747 or go to his website, vinnychopra.com.